Hello guys, and welcome to a new Steel Division video today by me, Vulcan. Today I have for you Bumblebeepotato versus Nicholas Fricke in round one of the first North American tournament. Today we are going to be seeing Colombelles, and on the Allied side we have the 4th Armoured under command of Bumblebee, and on the Axis side we have the 1st SS Panzer. So this is a very nice map. I really do like Colombelles. I think it's probably one of the better maps in Steel Division. It's quite nicely balanced, I feel, and gives a range of different playstyles due to obviously the close range engagement at the factory, and then you have the open ground on this bottom side here, and then you also have like this top strip of land that can favour rushes in some cases. So that's Colombelles, but let's have a look at these divisions and how they match up. So the 4th Armoured, they are well known for their fast Phase A gameplay. They have, of course, Hellcats, they've got the M8 Cavalries, and both of those combined can be extremely powerful in the early game. Then you have Abrams as well, comes in his M4, and is an extremely strong unit to have in the early game, because not only does he have the ability to take on enemy tanks very well, but also has the ability to absolutely annihilate infantry with the 5 HE on the main gun, the 50 cal, the 30 cals. It's just insane. So a fantastic support tank for your standard infantry on the 4th Armoured, which are your rifles, of course, and you've got plenty of them. Alongside those, you've got cavalry scouts, and there's just quite a lot of nice, good units that you can rely on. If AT guns get in your way, you've got the B-26B Marauder. On the side of the 1st SS, they have the really cheap Stugs, the Stug 3s. These kind of save the early game for the 1st SS. Without these Panzerjäger Stugs, I think this division would be in trouble. But those are available. And it's not the first time that I've seen two placed down at the start. I've sometimes even seen three. I tried it myself on a video once. Yeah, it went pretty well in the early game until they all got killed in the mid game. Either way, let's have a look at what else is going down here for Nicholas Fricke. So he's got Panzergrenz and the Sturm Pioneers. The Sturm Pioneers will actually be very, very strong for contesting this factory early. If he can get them into Bumblebee's side of the factory here, he can definitely do a lot of damage around these buildings with those flamethrowers. The Volksdeutsche, they're going to be just sort of backing that up, engaging from range. I think I called these Panzergrenz, but they're Volksdeutsche. That's the main infantry that makes up the 1st SS Panzer. And then they're obviously going to be followed up by the command infantry there. On the bottom side, two more Volksdeutsche and that Stug 3. If we jump over to Bumblebee now, we can see what he's actually placed down. It is going to be a cavalry scout for the top side, just one WC-52. Likely going to be holding the frontline forwards up there. Multiple rifles heading to the factory with an M20 command to give them that much needed veterancy. Further down we have the Hellcat accompanied by a Jeep 30 cal and the recon. And at the very bottom it's going to be two units of rifles, cavalry scouts and the WC-52 and an M8 cavalry. Now I think the M8 cavalry would probably be better suited towards the factory, as it will be able to put down its machine gun fire quite nicely. And then the Hellcat can deal with whatever it comes across on the bottom side. The Stugs, though, if they get within the 1,000 meter range, they could be extremely good for dealing with Hellcats. That's basically reliant on the veterancy, though. And if there is command nearby, these Stugs are 2-star in the early game, and they can be very, very strong snipers that Nicholas Fricke might be able to make use of. But the Hellcat coming out here, going to take shots at the 2-2-2, takes it out straight away, and off the bat the Hellcat paying dividends, getting rid of that fire support unit for Nicholas Fricke. So Aufklärer are going to want to get into a decent position. Volksdeutsche probably want to run down into these buildings and get into cover, but at the moment, yeah, Aufklärer look like they're going to end up pinned or maybe even killed off. Doesn't want that to happen, doesn't want to get rid of his recon early on, since the 1st SS do definitely lack recon in general. Looks like the Jeep 30 cals are going to be going for the surrender. The Stug 3 is not covering the main road, so that's going to be one Volksdeutsche dealt with, and the Aufklärer do not hold the front line forwards. It looks like Bumblebee is going to try and just run them down, already finding himself a +1 in the early game. Very, very nice job by Bumblebee. The 2-2-2 being killed off provides no threat to this Jeep 30 cal. And, well, the Jeep just dealing with the Aufklärer and the Volksdeutsche, and there's nothing the Stug can do about it. Now, the Stug maybe could drive over here and deal with that, but the Hellcat's going to continue pressing forwards. He's got an M8 cavalry on his flank, and that could be quite awkward. So Bumblebee, it looks like he's just going to move it back, try and get it behind one of these buildings. If he can do so, then he can just maintain this little salient that he's built for himself. Jeep, is it going to get out of line of sight? Yes, it is. The Stug hadn't turned round in time. So meanwhile, in the factory, the Sturm Pioneer is going to be using their smoke grenades to create cover for themselves as they approach the buildings. Bumblebee, rightly so, just backing off. Does not want to get in the face of those flames just yet. Or at all, really. Ooh, JU-87 comes in for the strike onto the Hellcat, but the Hellcat gets into cover, is not in line of sight of Nicholas Fricke because he doesn't have the recon anymore, and does survive the JU-87 strike. So Nicholas Fricke, he might be able to keep that round for a little while. It's very unlikely that Bumblebee has any fighters. Normally it's just a B-26B in Phase A, so he's going to be reliant on AA really to stop the JU-87 from being a factor. But either way, we did see the WC-52 go down. It's not a massive kill, but it definitely takes away some of the pressure that 50 cal could have put onto the Volksdeutsche down here. Over in the factory, the Sturm Pioneers have made it without taking any losses at all into the other side of the factory, which is very nice positioning for Nicholas Fricke in the early game, and it seems as though these Sturm Pioneers have paid off and gained him that ground in the mid. But currently it is 56% in favour of Bumblebee. That is providing him with a plus one, and it is ticking up slowly but surely. WC-52 going to be engaging Volksdeutsche on the top side, thanks to the cavalry scout spotting those in the open. This JU-87, I think it may as well just leave at the moment, because you don't want to give Bumblebee a reason to buy an AA, and that's exactly what he's done. MGMC is on its way to save the day and stop the Hellcat from being killed off in the future. M20 Command going to be helping pin down these Volksdeutsche. They found themselves in a pretty sticky spot. That rifle squad needs to jump forwards now if it wants to get the surrender before they run too far out of range, because that would be a very nice pickup there and give more ground to Bumblebee, and he's certainly finding a lot of ground. Plus two now on the board. WC-52 does get taken out by the Stug on the top side. Hellcat's going to be coming in there to deter that. This Hellcat's certainly getting very close to the Stug in the mid. That's going to be an engagement we're going to have to watch out for, because at close range, this Hellcat could definitely do a ton of damage and just pop that Stug before the Stug really gets on target. So we'll have to wait and see if that's the case. But for now, Bumblebee just going to reverse it, keep it hidden, as he doesn't want to get hit by another airstrike. M8 cavalry is also on the way over. If he can 2v1 this Stug, that would be fantastic. Nicholas Fricke knows what's up though. Going to be bringing in his Puma. And now he can also have two units that can match up to Bumblebee's. And this Puma with the 2-star veterancy is not too bad. It can definitely provide a lot of fire. It looks like it's going to be coming round to maybe try and flank these units. 222 pressing up the road. Not convinced that this is the right place to have a 222 right now. Although, I guess it could kill the Hellcat at close range. At 800 meters, it does have that 4 AP. So at this range, that is a solid 7 AP on that 20mm, which is quite a lot versus like the 3 armor and the 4 armor. Yeah, look at that. The 222 takes out the Hellcat. That is an amazing kill for the 222 to get. And very, very nice. Basically gets revenge for the other 222 that previously died to the Hellcat. Yeah, those 20mm can be very, very strong at close range, especially against the weaker armor of these 4th armored units. So Nicholas Fricke doing very well to make that happen. Now this Puma and the Stug can probably 2v1 this M8 cavalry if they want to. But what I would rely on is possibly just some Panzerstrecks or like the Panzerfaust from like Volksdeutsche into these buildings, just to kind of run through there, force the M8 cavalry back, and then have an engagement with the Puma at range, because you don't really want to like trade one for one with an M8 cavalry, because M8 cavalry only costs 65 points, whereas a Puma costs 100 and the Stug costs 110. So if the M8 cavalry does trade, it's going to be much more value for money for Bumblebee early on, which is, yeah, something you want to avoid. So this Puma, what has it found? It's going to be shooting at those rifles. Stern Pioneer's just holding back in his factory. I really like the positioning of these Stern Pioneers. He could probably go one more house forwards, honestly, one more factory building. But for now, just holding the front line there is good for Nicholas Fricke. Maintaining factory control is great because it takes away one more avenue that you can be flanked upon if you want to put a lot of emphasis on this bottom side, which I think is the first SS you really want to do. Since you will have Panthers in Phase B, if you can afford one, it will really give you a lot of breathing room down here on this bottom side that you can use to take advantage of the light armored units, once again, of Bumblebee. So, yeah, at the moment, Stern Pioneer is just holding the ground, Fokusdeutsche on the top and mid. There was a plus two briefly for Bumblebee, but it seems as though Nicholas Fricke is gaining himself back a little bit of ground, just enough to keep it at a plus one. And if he can continue to do that, then that would be fantastic. And look at this, lovely stuff from the Fokusdeutsche. Are going to be jumping forwards, building to building, and trying to get into the next one so they can get a Panzerfaust into the M8 Cavalry, and taking that out without risking the Puma or the Stug is very, very nice indeed. Stug is currently being hit in the side armor, though, by this M18 Hellcat. Does not manage to find the kill in time. Oh, here comes the JU-87. Is the AA in line of sight? No, it's not. The M16 MGMC is being engine destroyed by the Stug 3 on this bottom side. So Bumblebee actually going to lose his AA piece in this early game, which will allow and enable this JU-87 to do a lot of damage onto some of these light vehicles and also the Hellcat there. So the Fokusdeutsche once again being pushed back in the mid. The rifle's doing a good job of that at close range, especially at that range. The 8HE certainly comes out on top compared to the 5 that the Fokusdeutsche can present. The other thing about it is the Fokusdeutsche do have the disheartened trait, but the JU-87 is going to come in onto Abrams. This could be devastating. If Bumblebee loses Abrams this early on, that could be very bad, but not going to happen this time around. JU-87 does not have to retreat anytime soon, though. It might have to towards Phase B, unless the fuel, I guess, could force Nicholas Fricke to head back to base, and it looks like it's going to do so. First thing I expect Bumblebee to invest upon in Phase B is either more AA or a airplane of his own, because this is very, very scary at the moment. Having that JU-87 just like free reign is just something that you don't want to deal with as a 4th Armored. These Bantams, though, they're certainly making a run through the back line of Nicholas Fricke, helping Bumblebee maintain a plus 2 once again. The mobile playstyle of the 4th Armored certainly coming into play here. MGMC plus the Hellcat, they're going to help finish off these Fokusdeutsche, I would assume. And the infantry so far for Nicholas Fricke has just not done too well. He has done in the top, in the factory, getting these Stern Pioneers into position, but they haven't really killed too much. These Bantams, they've been countered by a 2-3-2. Nice job by Nicholas Fricke to get that in. Simple response, really, to these two Bantams. It's just annoying that they did create that plus two for a little while, as it does help count up the points just a little bit more for Bumblebee throughout the game. But there goes the second one, WC-52 now charging forwards. That's into the face of two MG-42s, though. So it could actually go down to these Fokusdeutsche, and it is going to do so. So, yeah, a little bit of a mistake there from Bumblebee. It's always best to keep those WC-52s at range because they don't have any armor themselves. It's a lot like these Jeep 30 cals. Like, you can imagine the same thing happening here. The Fokusdeutsche with those MG-42s, yeah, killing the Jeep. Easy peasy. 232, though, has got a weapon jam. The Hellcat did get line of sight onto that 232. Nicholas Fricke is actually going to have to be very careful with his Puma now, because if a 1,200 meter range engagement does occur with this Puma, he has nothing he can do about it. Like, that's going to be really bad. At the moment, the only reason that that's not occurring is because the Stug is covering the flank, but Abrams is going to be coming in there, taking the shot, gets a weapon jam with the first hit, and that is lovely stuff for Abrams. Going to be able to finish it off most likely, and then the Hellcat can come around the corner, start poking at the 232 and the Puma, really break this bottom side open for Bumblebee. We've got to remember, though, the JU-87 is still a thing, and there is a Panther G on the way straight away into Phase B, so very, very nice I like the choice of that Panther G for sure. We'll blunt this push. And it's just a matter of keeping this Puma out of line of sight if he can. The Hellcat should be quick enough, really, to just drive forwards and get into a place where it's constantly in line of sight of the Puma, and then can just take shots for free, because that Puma looks like it's just trying to find a hiding position right now. But a Hellcat on each of its flanks is not very fun to deal with, but has managed to hide itself behind the trees for now. So it's all about this Panther. What can this Panther do when it comes in? Also, in the meanwhile, on the top side, the M8 Cavalry is chewing up some Volksdeutsche, but the Stug's going to have something to say about that. And we do see that some Aufklärer do go down there. Abrams has moved forwards, gets a driver wounded onto the Puma. That Puma's not going anywhere. M18 Hellcat does come in. Does not take the shot, though. I think the Hellcat just wants to try and get close to this Panther G. Oh, engine destroy there onto Abrams. Really nice first shot from the Panther G, but the Cavalry Scouts make it into the face of the Stug 3. And now we have the Ju-87 coming in. Oh, explosions everywhere as the Puma, the Hellcat, and the Abrams go down. Very, very nice response by Nicholas Fricke, cleaning up that push well and truly. The MGMC has nowhere to go. The Panther G is going to be looking for that kill, or at least I hope it would, because getting rid of the MGMC enables that Ju-87 for the rest of the game. So, incredible stuff so far. The M18 Hellcat going down. Yeah, and the Abrams and M4 Abrams there. Just really, really bad for Bumblebee. It looks like he did invest in two M5A1s to just kind of put pressure onto that bottom side, but in the meantime up here, fantastic job by Bumblebee to take out both the 232 and the Stug 3. He managed to pop the Stug 3 here with the Cavalry Scouts, and these Cavalry Scouts may be invaluable. You've got the Cavalry Scouts in this building. The Panther G will not know that they are there. We also see the B-26B Marauder coming in now with the P-38 Lightning. It was to be expected that into Phase B there would be airplanes purchased by Bumblebee, as he doesn't want those Ju-87s to be a thing anymore. Oh, this Cavalry Scouts has run out, takes one bazooka shot at the Panther G, but fails to find the kill. That is very, very important, because Bumblebee, oh, can he find it? Second shot, transmission damage onto the Panther G is forcing it to fall back. Hellcat's going to have shots. Nicholas Fricke in trouble. Panther G goes down. He can't afford that. It's going to push into a plus two. And that is really, really bad news for Nicholas Fricke. It's back to a plus one for the time being due to the half-track and pioneers coming in. But as soon as those are dealt with, this is soon to be a plus two. Also, these M5A1s, they are just riding through the factory. They are looking for these Sturm Pioneers, because the Sturm Pioneers can't really do too much to affect them. Meanwhile, the Air Force is just going to continue to strafe any infantry that Nicholas Fricke comes in with. And God, this game has been swung backwards and forwards. One of the M5A1s does go down. It finds a Volksdeutsche, but these Sturm Pioneers, wow, they just absolutely annihilated the infantry presence for Bumblebee. And wow, that's a lot of ground gained there for Nicholas Fricke. Those infantry certainly paying off. Just keeping Bumblebee at bay. So the M5A1, that's going to be helping out with the B-26Bs to just keep these units pinned. M8 Cavalry is going to take out the half tracks. Just incredible stuff. Ju-87 though is going to come in. There is an MGMC that is going to have the shot, but one shot from the Ju-87 comes in, kills the Hellcat. Lovely stuff. So back and forth this game so far. We saw the trade for the M4 and M4 Abrams and on the M18, sorry. Then we saw the Panther G go down. Now we see the next Hellcat go down. It's just so back and forth. And look at this front line just shifting so damn much. We might even see a plus one on the board here for Nicholas Fricke. Especially if this M8 Cavalry goes down, it's drove right into the line of sight of a Pac-40. That driver wounded means it's not going anywhere, and the Pac-40 is going to find the kill. Cavalry Scouts do not hold the front line forwards, and Bumblebee is in tatters right now. He's been taken apart, and these B-26Bs, yes, they are irritating, but at the end of the day, it's not boots on the ground, and Nicholas Fricke is certainly going to be able to make back loads of points here. Finds himself a plus two. If he can get in the reinforcements, then he'll be in a very, very good spot. But it's interesting how both players have exactly the same income. It really is going to come down to the quality of units. And with a Panther G arriving on this top side, that should solidify that position quite nicely. It's on the bottom side that I'm worried, however, since Bumblebee is just going to be able to use his MGMC to hold the line right now, which is something that you wouldn't expect very often. The other thing that's kind of interesting is there's one rifle squad down here with three men standing off against six Volksdeutsche. If Nicholas Fricke goes a bit aggressive with these Volksdeutsche, he might be able to just find even more ground on this bottom side. But the shift in territory has just been immense throughout this game so far. Cavalry scouts are just going to hold their fire. Never mind, Bumblebee allows them to open up. May have been a bit premature. I think it would have been nice to keep those cavalry scouts there patiently until the Panther G rolled on by, because I believe from here they do have the 200 meter range onto that road. It could be something that Nicholas Fricke still gets caught out by, though, since I don't believe he's noticed. P-38 Lightnings are going to come in and strafe up one of the Volksdeutsche. The Gepard has come in. It's going to be taking on the MGMC with the two-star veterans. See there, a 20mm unit should be able to beat the MGMC. It's always funny how we're sort of comparing AA units as they go up against each other. But these cavalry scouts, they're going to be revealed. Since they weren't on return fire, I believe they opened up onto the Pioneers. And yeah, that's a missed opportunity, I feel, for Bumblebee. Maybe the Pioneers would have found them anyway. But this Panther G was certainly moving up that train track very, very quickly indeed. So it looks like these P-38 Lightnings are just going to be trying to strafe these ground forces, but coming up against these Gepards now is not good for them, and Bumblebee doesn't want to get caught out over enemy AA, so it's going to be retreating for now. So on this bottom side, there is going to need some substance for Nicholas Fricke. I would suggest things like Panzer IVs if he has them on his division. They will be very, very useful for picking off things like these MGMCs, the half-tracks that bring in reinforcing infantry, even the M5A1s that Bumblebee seems to be relying upon on this bottom side. So that would be a very nice unit. Meanwhile, just this Panther G on the top side is causing so much presence. But a nice kill there for Bumblebee. Does manage to use his grenade to kill off one of the Stern Pioneers in the factory. That's one down, one to go. If he can take out the second one, then there's not actually too much standing in his way. MGMC getting the better of these Pioneers. Hellcat picks off one of the half tracks. There is a Pack 40 on the way down here. That could be the answer to this armored support that Bumblebee has. Now, that half-track on this bottom side, it was killed off by the Volksdeutsche, but the armored LMG rifles and rifles made short work of those. Can this Pack 40 find the kill onto the MGMC? This MGMC is getting pretty low on ammunition, but still has plenty left. That's like 900 rounds. Use them up pretty quickly, though. Wow. JU-87 is going to come in. Surprised I didn't go for a shot onto the MGMC, but here we go. Pack 40 at close range. Bam, one shot. To be expected. B-26 B Marauder is going to come in and target that straight away, but not in time to save the AA. So now we have the M5A1 here. That's going to be assisting infantry back into this factory, and well, considering how much the territory swung in favor of Nicholas Fricke, it swung right back again with 58% territory in favor of Bumblebee. Maintaining the lead, I just think that Nicholas Fricke didn't have enough on the map to really take full advantage of his situation. But a lovely air engagement here for Bumblebee. Going to get onto the back of a two-star Focke-Wulf. And a second one brought in by Nicholas Fricke. Seems like a bit of a panic buy to me. And that could be very, very scary if that gets shot down. This P-38 Lightning has got a fuel leak. And that's incredible. So P-38 coming in on the back of that Focke-Wulf. I'm not entirely sure if this is actually going to go in favour of Bumblebee after all this. This Focke-Wulf certainly getting on the back of this Lightning slowly, but surely one more burst of its machine guns and it should be able to do the job. There we go. One down, one to go. Interesting air engagement. It's just going to try and break away from the Lightning. How the Lightning's going to get well on its tail. Or the Gepard's getting involved, the B-26 B Marauder's getting involved. Focke-Wulf's in trouble. B-38 Lightning is low on fuel. Not sure it's going to be able to get in range in time. Incredible stuff. Just a small air engagement there to watch while the rest of the map lays dormant. more or less. Pack 40 coming in for P-38 coming into the strafe and run onto the Pack 40, get shot down in the end by the Gepard. A little bit overconfident there for the Lightning. Nice try, but couldn't quite make that one work. M4-105 has now come in for Bumblebee. Is going to allow him to mop up the Pack 40. But yeah, just a simple Panzer IV on this bottom side would be fantastic for taking care of these units that Bumblebee are using. But the thing is, Bumblebee has all of the information right now, especially on this bottom side. He knows what's up. He's got cavalry scouts and recon in really good positions. Whereas Nicholas Fricke barely knows anything about the composition of forces he's up against, especially on the bottom side. So that may be why he hasn't brought in a Panzer IV just yet and is relying on his own tactics. But P-38 is going to get the kill onto the Ju-87, and then that is exactly why these P-38s were purchased. So fantastic job. Some nice micro in the mid here. Sturm Pioneers do manage to dodge out one of the grenades from the engineers. However, at this range, I think the flamethrowers can't actually fire. So this is an interesting engagement for sure. The grenade is going to aim and be thrown. Nicholas Fricke needs to jump out the way of that. I don't think he saw it thrown. Okay, maybe he did. Just moved out in time. Really nice infantry micro from both players here. Very, very good indeed. Okay, now the engineers are out in the open. Flamed to death. Poor guys. Right now the M5A1 has found and is going to start chewing up these Volksdeutsche. Panther D has arrived on this bottom side. These are the 200 point Panther Ds that the 1st SS Panzer has access to, and they can certainly make a difference in the late game since there's not too much armor on the field at the moment for the 4th Armored. We don't see the spam of Hellcats, we see the spam of M5A1s. And these M5A1s, they are very cheap. They are only 65 points a pop, and they do have the 8 AP and 6 armor. So they're the better Stuarts, and they're very, very cheap. So that's why a lot of people rely on them in the 4th Armored. They can be great for taking advantage of salients. But it's going to be, I think, reliant on this M5 gun in the top side to clean up the Panther G. However, getting infantry to wipe out these Pioneers can be very hard, since those Pioneers do still have grenades, and that means they might be able to destroy enemy infantry squads that come towards them. Now, this Panther D, it is going to have to be careful. Almost got a shot there onto the M4-105, but Bumblebee backs off. There is some cavalry scouts. They are on return fire. Do they fire at this truck though, or do they just let it pass? I think the truck might actually spot them. Yeah, it will. So that's going to reveal the location of those cavalry scouts to Nicholas, and as long as he noticed that, I think he did, those cavalry scouts are pretty doomed. On this bottom side, 2-star 259 going to be trying to take on these rifles at the 50 meter range. Rifles can kill the 259, so Nicholas Fricke does have to be careful of that. You can see them throwing them there. Two 259s coming up the main road to support the Panther D. This 259 managed to just get out of range. This Pioneer should probably come along and reveal those. On the top side, another 259 takes shots at the M3 half-track, gets killed by the M5 gun. That's going to reveal its location. But all the while, plus one for Bumblebee, sitting comfortably in this match. Pack 40 is going to take shots at this M5A1, gets a crew wounded with the first shot. Half-track goes down in the meantime to the Panther G. P-38 doesn't quite find the pin, and the M5A1 does go down. Focke-Wulf 190 coming in for the run onto the B-26. B Marauder is going to leave itself in a pretty dodgy position here. However, the P-38 has been forced to fall back, so maybe this Focke-Wulf can stick around. However, it looks like Nicholas Fricke is going to think better of that as two more B-26Bs come in. 259s are being dealt with by the M5A1 on this bottom side. This Panther D can't really get into a decent spot at the moment, and it is going to cause issues for Nicholas Fricke moving forwards, because all Bumblebee really needs to do is just hide behind these tree lines at the moment. And Nicholas, what he needs to do is get like a bunch of Volksdeutsche and start pushing on it. And then if anything comes and tries to like kill them while they're running across the open field, then the Panther D should cover that. So that's the only way that Nicholas Fricke can make that work. But he's having to compensate on the other side of the map at the same time. So he's investing points up here. And also it's just a very, very long thing to do. Like, it's going to take time. Infantry, of course, doesn't walk at lightning speed. So you can't really make that work out very quickly indeed. M5A1, however, that's going to be pushing its luck against the 259. Honestly, I'd like to see this Panther D behind the factory. Come towards where this 259 is, and then have the Panther D come down to the very bottom here so that Nicholas Fricke can cover both sides of this tree line as he pushes up to the point where the Volksdeutsche get into this tree line and then can force the M5A1 back, or it will just get killed. So that's kind of what I'm looking for down there. Meanwhile though, 259 is going to come through, kill off a half track. M5 gun does have line of sight though, going to find the weapon jam and the fallback. Pack 40 takes that half track on the top side. I'm pretty sure this M5 gun got things covered. Also the B-26 B Marauder coming in there, gonna strafe that 259 to death. So it's interesting, 259 trying to push forwards in the mid. The M4-105 though, if that gets a shot on target, will blow up the 259s. I feel like 259s in the late game, yes, they can be good if you're like really ahead, but otherwise I just think their liabilities, you know, they get killed off so damn easy. This Gepard getting killed by a Hellcat on the bottom side. Focke-Wulf 190 comes in again. The P-38 Lightning has been purchased by Bumblebee. Oh, that Focke-Wulf 190 turned away from the P-38 Lightning engagement is going to get shot down, and that is the second two-star Focke-Wulf dealt with by Bumblebee. M4-105 now engaging the next Gepard, although that's going to be taken out by the Panther D. Lovely shot there. Oh, snapshot by the M5A1 takes out the 259 on the move. Panther D is being engaged on this bottom side. I think Bumblebee might be trying to go for a quick close range engagement here. But this M5A1, that is getting a little bit too big for its boots. It's going to be pushing around. It's going to distract the Panther. Oh, maybe not. M5A1 gets the internal fragment onto the Panther D. Second shot gets the weapon jam from the M18 Hellcat. And that Panther D is a sitting duck to this M18 Hellcat. Lovely kill there. HS-129 is going to be coming in. Oh, lovely first shot there from the HS-129B3. Cleans up the Hellcat, almost takes out the M5A1 with all of these airplanes in the air. That is one very dead HS-129. I love the way this B-26B Marauder uses its side gun to like take that out. It's rather funny. So interesting, it's left Bumblebee in an advantageous position down here, I feel. But the Panther D going to be coming down to make the difference. Look at this Flampanzer just rolling through the factory in the mid. It's forced back two engineers by the looks of things. It's coming back to try and take down these rifles. Volksdeutsche just very low on men there, but still able to provide that frontline presence. This Flampanzer, yeah, looking for the kill onto these infantry squads, but the M18 Hellcat will be there to cover. P-38s are trying to strafe the Panther D at the moment, but that Panther D has already dealt with that M5A1. So both of the armor pieces for Bumblebee have been killed off on this bottom side, but it's not taking the plus one away from Bumblebee. He's still maintaining the ground, which is incredible. What an absolutely awesome game this has been so far. Another Panther D is going to be on its way for Nicholas Fricke. Panther G almost finds a shot onto the Hellcat on the top side, but not quite. Rifles do get cleaned up in the factory. Flampans are going to be looking for the infantry kills further down. The fast move there, though, is rather odd, following the road all the way around. I guess it might be quicker than driving all the way across, but either way, we'll probably bump into these engineers at some point, and these ones as well, and the Flampanzer will be able to take those out, giving the plus one finally to Nicholas Fricke. Saying that, the Hellcat is making a salient up here, but it's not going to matter. M18 Hellcat gets popped by the Panther G. Bit of a miss micro there, I feel, from Bumblebee. Would have probably wanted to attack move around that corner rather than just move into the line of sight of the Panther D so easy. but this M18 Hellcat is going to be looking for the kill onto the Panther D. I don't think he needs to worry about this Flam Panzer since he has another Hellcat coming in, wants to probably use that in that position. So this Hellcat has all day long now to really take shots at this Panther D and should be doing so before it recovers. Otherwise, the Hellcat engaging the Panther D could be incredibly risky. This Flam Panzer did manage to surrender both of these units in the mid here, but coming under fire now from these B-26B Marauders. Hellcat, ooh, keeps missing. Internal fragments onto this M18 Hellcat. I believe this Panther D on the main road did manage to make that happen. Oh, I was going to say lovely kill, but the Volksdeutsche missed the Panzerfaust shot onto the M5A1. The chance was there. This M5A1 now looking for a shot into this Panther. At that range, I feel like it's going to struggle to penetrate unless it classes as a side shot. And meanwhile, the Volksdeutsche closing the gap onto the Stuart once again to find another Panzerfaust shot. This Flam Panzer still alive on the main road. This is incredible stuff. Volksdeutsche take out the M501. The Panther D is going to be surviving for the time being. Those armored LMG rifles, they are in a pretty tough spot. But 7 minutes and 25 seconds left on the clock. Can Nicholas Fricke break through the 4th Armoured? I feel like these B-26Bs are certainly causing a hell of a lot of issues for Nicholas at the moment. Must be so irritating to deal with. But this Gepard's out of ammunition. There is an SD Gev Z-70 on the way. So an investment in more AA. It's good to see. But as you can see, it doesn't do too much suppression to a B-26B. But Volksdeutsche there taking out one of the Hellcats. They were hiding in the tree line. No recon left really on this bottom side for Bumblebee. He's got this one unit of recon, but it's just not really in a good place to spot things on the front line anymore. Plus two now for Nicholas, but he's going to need a plus three if he wants to win this game. All of the B-26Bs strafing the Panther G. M8 Command is going to come around, try and take the shot there. Probably needs to get right next to that Panther G to find the kill, otherwise he's going to be bouncing all day long. The best thing to do would just be fast, move it down here, get behind it, maybe just even make it surrender. Flam Panzer is on its way over though, might be able to cover that off. But in the meantime, Panther Ds are making ground down here. They are certainly doing a lot of damage throughout this game using that value for money. Bumblebee certainly doing a great job. Forces back the Flam Panzer there. Now the M8 Command going for that fast move straight towards the Panther. That's what I like to see. Flam Panzer does go down. M8 Command is going to surrender this Panther G most likely. You'd hope so. There we go. Panther G goes down. So this is kind of taking away a lot of ground from Nicholas Fricke on this top side. Probably enough that Bumblebee will be able to secure himself the victory. These B-26Bs though, I would just hate to be Nicholas Fricke right now because they are just so damn irritating. Stug 3 has come in on this top side, does take the shot, gets the internal fire onto the M8 Command. M8 Command is going to do a runner. This Stug really just needs to fire at the M8 Command. I'm not entirely sure what it's doing. It's on like an attack move order, but for some reason it is not stopping to fire. Okay, is going to be doing so now. Takes the shot, misses. M8 Command going to be taking a little while to get behind that tree line. Thing is, we're looking at like a plus 4 lead needed at this moment for Nicholas Fricke to win the game. And that's just really, really hard to find at this point. Unless the Stug 3 can kill both the Hellcat and the M8 Command on this top side, break through this infantry and the M5 gun. But that is a very tough task indeed, because there's no airstrikes to make it happen quickly, right? You'd have to rely on infantry probably to take out the M5 gun, or maybe just a bit of artillery. And both of those options are very, very slow. So 4 minutes left. Oh, nice kill there. Hellcat does the damage but takes the Panzerfaust in the rear. Panther D for Hellcat. I think Bumblebee will take that. The only annoying part is it's not affecting the front line anymore, so the Hellcat is causing that loss of conquest ground, but the M5 gun opening up there onto the Stug. The Stug did get the better of the Hellcat, but the M5 gun being there in support is going to destroy the hopes and dreams of Nicholas Fricke moving forwards in this tournament. Hellcat engaging on the half tracks in the factory there. This has been an absolutely incredible game. Those Panther Ds still advancing. There's plenty of air force available for Bumblebee to just strafe these Panther Ds and maybe get in another Hellcat to start killing things off. This Hellcat, for example, is in a prime position to kill the Panther D if multiple B-26Bs come in again to strafe the Panther D. Even they could probably strafe the SDKF Z-72 to death. But these Volksdeutsche finding ground and taking out another M5A1 there. Mistakes have definitely been made from Bumblebee, allowing his units to be taken out by those Panzerfausts. It's not something you really want to see when you're playing the game, because it's just a severe lack of recon or just infantry support for your armor in general that causes those things to happen. So definitely avoidable, but either way in this case, it looks like Bumblebee has just put all his effort into this top side just to maintain ground up here. Keep it at the plus one. In comes the P-38 Lightnings once again. They're going to be strafing the SDKF Z-72. Trying to get rid of that. Probably open the doors for the B-26Bs to come in. But as you can see, it's staying at a plus one. Bumblebee just bringing in enough that it does not go any further than that. And, well, it looks like on this top side, Stug is going to get hit by the Hellcat here. Does have the veterancy from their main command, plus the 6 base accuracy. And Stug 3 goes down. We will probably look at a plus 2, yeah, before the end of the game. Maybe even a plus 3. But at this point, it just doesn't matter. Nicholas Fricke just too far behind. Bumblebee got the job done. And some just insane engagements that could have gone either way. There was a moment where Nicholas Fricke gained tons of ground, but just didn't really have the units on the map to take advantage of it. And then Bumblebee just took back all the ground afterwards. So that was just annoying for Nicholas Fricke, the mobility of Bumblebee allowing him to just kind of bounce back from that. And it's just one of the very big strengths of the 4th Armored, is just their mobility and their ability to sort of bounce back from all sorts of engagements, and also just have the right answers to all different engagements as well. So Panther D there, it's in a really good position to just cover the advance of these Volksdeutsche. And I said that this would be a strategy that Nicholas Fricke could rely on, is just running forwards the Volksdeutsche, have the Panther D to cover them as they move forwards. And it seems like in this late game that is certainly what he is relying on. But it is not going to gain him enough ground quickly enough to make the difference. So Volksdeutsche now moving into these buildings. P-38 Lightning coming in with a bit of a strafing run there. But there is 8 seconds left, 5 seconds left, and it is all over. Unfortunately, Nicholas Fricke, valiant attempt, could not find the ground he needed to get the victory in this case. 40 minutes does pass, and Bumblebee with 3,930 kills to 3,550 losses. Very close KD for a game that lasted this long, and I think it certainly showed with the swing of territory throughout the game. Bumblebee, though, certainly on point with his mobility and using that to his advantage to find territory across the entire map. Maybe not in the late game, of course. Nicholas Fricke coming back hard there, but just not in time. This Hellcat getting the Panther G and a Puma kill is very, very nice. Pays itself off like 4 times over. P-38 did kill off the Ju-87, Focke-Wulf 190, and a Panther G. That probably counts because it made it fall back and then the Panther G got surrendered. That would otherwise be a very odd kill to see. M5 gun, 259 there. Panzerjägerstug Some really nice kill lists. This JU-87 though, it's a shame that couldn't find the Hellcat early on, because that could have been something that Nicholas Fricke could have exploited. The use of this JU-87 by Nicholas Fricke was really good. I think he identified that there wasn't really much air force available to Bumblebee early on, so that JU-87 was pretty much free to take shots at those Hellcats early if there was no M16 MGMCs, and the one that did come in got killed by the Stug. 232 responding to the Bantams was the perfect response, so very nice job there. Pack 40 did a decent job. This Panther G, it found a few kills, but it's very hard to pay yourself off with these Panther Gs. The Panther Ds, however, much easier since they are way cheaper than usual. But an interesting game nonetheless, very exciting, especially through the mid game. So congratulations to Bumblebee, going to be moving on to the next round. Commiserations to Nicholas Fricke, will be dropping down to the lower bracket, but I won't be covering those games. So, last we've seen of Nicholas Fricke, Bumblebee, congratulations. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.